Good morning, all of you. Today we will start a new chapter, that is chapter number 8, comparing quantities. This chapter you have studied in your previous class also. So let's remind that the what you have studied in your previous classes. So first you have studied about ratio. Ratio means suppose you are given with number of boys given here is 42, okay, and number of girls given here is 40, okay. You are given with number of boys is 42 and number of girls is 40. You have to find ratio of number of girls to the number of boys. Okay, you are given with the question ratio of number of girls to the number of boys. So first what is given? Number of girls is given. So you can write down as 40. What is number of girl here? Number of girl is 40. Ratio means to the number of boys, and to the number of boys is 42. So this is the ratio, number of girls to the number of boys. Similarly, you have studied about percentage. Percentage means suppose you are given with 60% of boys, or you can maybe given as 40% of girls. So how you will do? 60 percentage means upon 100 into the number of boys, whatever will be the number of boys. In this way you will write down how you will calculate. In this way you have to calculate the percent. This you have studied in your previous step, previous class. So again what you have to given is, now what will be given, if you will be given with the ratio and you have to convert it into the percent, and similarly sometimes it will be given into percent and you have to convert in the ratio. Start karo. This is exercise 8.1. The first question, it says that find the ratio of the following. You are given with the sums and you have to find out the ratio. The first question, it says that speed of a cycle is 50 km per hour to the speed of the scooter is 30 km per hour. What is given to here is speed of cycle, it is given how much? 15 km per hour. Second, what you are given? To the speed of scooter. Speed of scooter. How much it is given? 30 km per hour. Okay, what you have to find out the ratio of this, means speed of cycle ratio speed of scooter. So I am writing C for cycle and ratio and S for scooter. What is speed of cycle? It is given as the unit of both are same. So I can write down, means I don't need to convert it here. Cycle is 50 km per hour and scooter is given here as 30 km per hour. So you can write down this as 15 by 30 also, okay. So from here you can cancel, 15 ones are and 15 twos are 30, okay. So you can write down in the ratio 1:2, okay. So what is the ratio of this sum? Speed of cycle to the speed of scooter is 1:2. This is the answer. So here we will convert 5 meter. Second proportionate given is 5 meter to 10 kilometer. Here both the units are different, so you cannot convert this. Firstly, what you have to do, you have to convert meter. This unit and this unit should be same. Either you convert both the units in meter or you convert both the units in kilometer. So you know that 1 kilometer equal to 1000 meter. So here I will convert this. 10 kilometer is 10 किलोमीटर विल बी इक्वल टू 10 इनटू 1000, सो दिस विल बिकम 10,000, ओके 10,000 मीटर. नाउ बोथ द यूनिट्स आर सेम, सो आई कैन फाइंड आउट द रेशियो. मीन्स दिस विल बी 5:10,000, ओके आई कैन राइट डाउन दिस इज 5/10,000, सो दिस विल बी 5 1s and 5 2s are 10, this is 2000, okay. Or in the form of ratio, how can you write down in the form of ratio? This will be 1:2000, okay. This is the answer. Similarly, here in the C portion it is given 50 paisa to rupees 5, and you know here also the units are not same. Here it is given in paisa and here it is given in rupee. So you know that 1 rupees equal to how many? 100 paise. 1 rupees equal to how many paise? 100 paise. So what I am going to do, either you can convert both in paise, or you can convert it in both the units into rupees. So I am converting into paise, so this will be quite easier. So I am taking as 5 rupees equal to 5 into 100, so this is 500 paise. Means here also 50 paise is there and here also 5 paise is there, both the units are same. So what I will do, I will find out the ratio, 50 paise ratio 500. So 50:500, or you can write down this as 50/500. This 0 and this 0 will get cancelled. 5 1s are 5 1s are, okay, 5 10s are, okay. Again then you can write down this as 1/10, or you can write down this as 1:10. This is the answer. This is question number 2. Here you have to convert the following into the percentage. Here you are given with the ratio. Here you have to convert this ratio into percent. And it's very, very easy. Just you need to do is like, you have to multiply it by how much? Multiply it by 100. So you are given with the ratio 3:4. So 3:4. You can write down this as 3/4, and for converting into percentage, just multiply it with 100, okay. So this is 2 2s are 4, 2 5s are 10, 2 1s are, 2 2s are, and 2 5s are, this is 3 into 25, 5 3s are 15, carry 1, 3 2s are 6 and 1 75, 75 75 percentage, okay. You have converted this ratio into percentage. 3:4, you have to convert it into percent. Just multiply it by 100. This ratio you can write down this and multiply, simplify, and you will get the answer in the percentage. So this is question number 3. In question number 3, it says that 72% of 29 students are good in mathematics. Okay, how many students are not good in mathematics? It is given that 72% of students are good in mathematics. So first I will write down number of students. I will find out those who are good in mathematics. Number of students good in mathematics. So number of students good in mathematics, how you will find out? 72% of 25 is given, okay. So this writ is given 72% of 25. 72% means 100 multiplied by 25, okay. So you can cancel it by 5. 5 5s are 25, 5 2s are 10, 5 1s are 5 4s are, okay. अगेन दिस इज टू टू ज़ा टू थ्री ज़ा टू सिक्स ज़ा टू वन ज़ा एंड टू वन ज़ा टू एट ज़ा. सो वट इज़ द आंसर हियर? 18 स्टूडेंट्स. What you got here is number of student good in mathematics is 72% of 25, and when you will take out 72% of 25, you will get 18 students. So number of student good in mathematics is 18. How many are not good in mathematics? So number of students not good in maths. So you can easily find out this. Means suppose here it is given 25. Out of 25, if you subtract number of good student, so you will get the number of student that they are not good in mathematics. Means 25 minus 18. So here you will give 7. 0, 7. Means number of student not good in mathematics is 7. But these are in number, and you have to and suppose you have to find this in percentage. So how you will find in percentage? So percentage, how you will convert 07 upon number of students not good in mathematics, for that I'm telling now. So 07 upon what is the total number of student here given is 25, just multiplied by 100. Okay, so 5 5s are 25, 5 2s are 10, 5 1s are 5 4s are, so 7 4s are 28. This is in percentage. This is in percentage. This is in number of student good in mathematics is not good in mathematics is 07. This is number of student. But if you have to take out in percentage, how much percent it is coming? It is coming 28%. So what was, how many are not good in mathematics? If we will ask number of students, so you will write down this. If it will ask in percentage, you can convert it into this. Okay, so number of student not good in mathematics is 07, and in percentage it is 28%. And one more trick is here. The 72% of 25 is given, and you note that from 100 only we take out the percent. So if you subtract 100 minus 72, then also you will get 28. So from here also you can easily find out the number of students that are not good in mathematics. So this was question number 3. Thank you.